This is why it's better to have one friend that you hang out with regularly instead of having a big group of friends. And trust me, you're gonna wanna listen to this story time. So when I was a sophomore in high school, I was kinda going through an identity crisis and low-key still am. I went to a predominantly white school for the majority of my life, so let's just say I was extremely whitewashed. It was one of those times in my life where if a white person said the N-word around me, I would just laugh. Not because I didn't know it was wrong, but because I wanted to be accepted and I wanted to be like everybody else and I seeked validation. Sophomore year was really when I started to become who I am today. I wanted to learn way more about my culture and my background. So I started becoming friends with people from other schools that are more diverse. Eventually, I met this group of girls, and I thought these girls were going to be the sweetest girls I would ever meet. Now, this friend group was serving flavor. I'm talking diverse to the T. One night, we decided that we were going to spend the night at one of the girls' houses. Let's call this girl Sally. I kept getting lost on the way to Sally's house, and I thought it was because I didn't know the area that well. Keep in mind, that's what I thought was the reason. I get there, and we watch like 4 or 5 movies before I end up falling asleep. And when I wake up, I was in a room full of grown-ass men staring at me. Storytime part 2 of why it's better to have one loyal friend instead of a big group of friends. I forgot to mention in part 1 that when I arrived, the men were already there. Mind you, we were in sophomore year. These men looked like they were in college. So I was already a little thrown off, but I trusted it because I was with my friend. When I wake up, these men are like staring at me, but they try to look away really fast, but I could tell that they were staring at me. I start thinking the worst of the worst. I try to think of any possible way that I could get out of there, whether it was physically or mentally. So I pretend to fall asleep just to escape the reality of it. But then one of the men at the bottom of the bed starts rubbing my feet. I immediately kick my leg so I can get his hands off. Now I'm thinking he's gonna be mad and I'm gonna get fucking attacked. So I try to make small talk to loosen the tension. So I look at the guys and I'm like, hey, do you know where the girls went? One of them looks at me and says, oh, they went home. So I'm like, I thought this was Sally's house. And they say nothing. So at this point, I think I'm being set up. I try my best to not make it seem like I'm suspicious of them. I casually act like I need to pee. Walk into the bathroom and I see a window. Automatically something clicks in my mind, get the fuck out of there. Making part 3 right now. Part 3 of why you should have one loyal friend instead of hanging out with a big group of friends. So I go into the bathroom and there's a window. I'm thinking to myself, I would be so dumb. I would be so extremely incredibly stupid to go back into that room full of grown ass men that I've never met before. Instead of making my escape through that window right here, right now. So I trusted my gut and I got the fuck out of there. Mind you, I'm in my PJs right now. No shoes, no socks. I'm making my great escape. Call me Pablo Escobar. While I was doing all of it, I was in disbelief. Like, I cannot believe that I'm escaping, like, right now. Like, this is actually insane. Like, I did what I believed was right at the moment. And honestly, that decision might be the reason why I'm alive right now. So I make a run for it. I immediately run to the front of the neighborhood. I hide behind some trees and then I call my sister. I call my sister instead of my parents because my mom was the one who drove me there. And if she knew that something bad happened, she wouldn't have let me go out again. I'm frantically explaining everything on the phone to my sister. She literally speeds to come get me. When she gets there, I immediately hop in her car and we get the fuck out of there. On our way home, I get a text from Sally. Last part is part 4. I'm making that right now. Part 4 of why you should have one loyal friend instead of having a big group of friends. So I'm on my way home and I get a text from Sally. Hey girl, where are you? We went to the gas station to get some milkshakes. You could have came with, but you were already asleep. I didn't even respond. I just blocked all of them because I know damn well that they were not getting milkshakes. Because one, why didn't they wake me up to get milkshakes? Because I wasn't the first person to fall asleep. I'd never fall asleep first at somebody's house with a big group of people. I saw somebody else who looked like they were sleeping, so I thought that I was good to fall asleep too. Two, why were all those grown ass men there? Nobody told me that they were going to be there. Like I said, we were sophomores. These men were in college. Maybe even graduated from college. They were grown. Three, why would she lie about it being her house? Four, why did the boy say she went home? I remember when I said I kept getting lost because I didn't know the area. Once I went back to look through the messages that I had with those girls to see if there was anything fishy going on, I noticed that they were all sending me different addresses. Either one number would be off or a letter would be off. They definitely were planning something because they were trying to get me there late. I haven't seen or talked to those girls since then. Okay, quick story time since I still have my makeup on. Let me tell you about this old lady that tried to fight me at Walmart. PSA to this old lady, if you're watching this, you could still get slapped any day. I don't like you and I'm willing to fight still. Waiting for you to try it the second time. Anyways, let's get into it. I was at Walmart with my sister because I go everywhere with my sister. We were just looking for a hair accessory. Because you know at Walmart sometimes they have those hidden gem items that you probably never thought would be there, but they're there and it's really cheap. So we go there to look for some cute hair accessories. I would just like to clarify that this old lady was white and I had a blonde wig on. Yeah, this old lady pulls up on us and she's like, one thing about me is I hate when people stare at me. What are you staring at? You need help? Gee, if you want to suck a little pussy, just fight it. Anyways, you know what I mean? Like, it's just mad judgmental. I feel like people are judging me. So I'm like, can I help you? She goes, can I touch your hair? Obviously, I say no because who is this old white lady trying to touch me? Don't know you. Don't know where you've been. Like, stay away. 6 feet. I don't know what it is about the people that live around me being so bold. I say no, you cannot touch my hair. And she reaches her old wrinkly hands. Next thing you know, she's tugging on my hair. Part 2 right now. The time an old lady tried to fight me at Walmart, part 2. So I thought that she was just gonna feel my hair. No, she takes her hand and starts tugging. And I'm like, what the fuck? Is this bitch doing? She's tugging on my hair. I'm like, can you, like, not fucking touch me? So, like, I move my head so then she can, like, let go. And she goes, fake. My sister steps in and she's like, you're not about to touch my sister like that. And you're not about to come up to us as an old white lady and pull our hair so you can see if it's fake or not. She's like, that's the problem these days. You black people don't know how to love yourself. This lady was looking for a fight. I was ready to fight. Something about me and my sister, we do not let nobody disrespect us. If you're old, black, white, short, four-year-old, we will get on your ass. So we like, hold on, you're not about to walk up to us and disrespect us, our space and our bubble and our privacy. You're not about to come up to us and try to pick an argument with us. Old as she is, I'm surprised she didn't have a heart attack. There was a worker really close by, so they came and was like, okay, what's going on? I was like, before I put this old white lady in her grave or have an early funeral, you better get her. As she was walking away, she was saying all types of racial slurs. Me and my sister did not give one fuck and went about our day. Period.
Story time at the time I dated a married man and his wife walked in on us. Mind you, I am 17, child. I promise it will all make sense in the end. Just keep watching. This literally happened in June. I turned 17 in May. I had just turned 17. Just makes everything worse. Let's just get into it. So at this time, my TikTok page was like plummeting. It was after I exposed my racist school and I started getting all those death threats. I basically had to stay off TikTok for a while and social media in general. So I wasn't really getting a lot of notice from anyone. But one day I noticed that this guy was liking all of my videos. And let me tell you this, man. Fine. This man was extra fine. So I was like, let me go ahead and shoot my shot. Honestly, if anyone were to blow up my notifs like that, I'd probably follow them anyway. So I followed him. Worst mistake of my life. The thing though is he only had a profile picture, but he did have a video. In the video, he was using a filter, so his face was covered up, but his hair and his bone structure matched his profile picture. So I was like, okay, this is him. I'm not gonna get catfish. Everything is good. Right? Anyway, so he DMs me on TikTok. He gives me his number. I text him and we start talking. He tells me that he's 19. Wait until you find out his actual age. Part two.
Get ugly. I've been through some shit, you might not wanna love me. Outlaw screaming thug life, only God can judge me. It's for all the hoes that played around when I was dusty. Didn't wanna fuck me.
Part two of the time I dated a married man and his wife walked in on us. So yeah, he tells me that he's 19. I'm 17, so I was thinking it's only 2 years and we're both at a very mature age. I was like, okay, that's fine. So we start talking more and we click like this. I really thought that I found the one for me. We had the same personality, same humor. We're interested in the same things. I had been single for 17 years, so I was excited. We keep talking and we plan to hang out one day. He said he wanted to take me on a little date or whatever. I was like, free food. Say fucking liz. So he comes to pick me up and we go out to a restaurant. Everything's good. I go home. Everything's fine. After that, we plan to hang out again and we go on another date. Everything's good. Everything's fine. Get home safely and I think everything's going good. But things start to get a little weird because the more as time went on, the more we would text and the more we would call. He started to randomly hang up when we were on FaceTime, or he would randomly put me on mute, or he would talk really quiet. I would ask him like why he was doing that and he would say, oh, my phone is glitching. Me being a dumb bitch, I believed it. I was like, you know what? All men aren't trash. Let me give him a chance. We continue to hang out. We hang out like 4 or 5 times until the night his wife came home. Part three of the time I dated a married man and his wife walked in on us. Okay, so since everything's going good, we continue to go on dates. We go on 3 or 4 dates and the last time we hung out was at his house. I was kind of confused on how he had a house at 19, but he said that he had a family business that he invested in. That's how he made his money, so he basically had his life set up for him. So I'm thinking, child, oh, he got money. He's cute. He has a nice personality. He's sweet. Like, what could go wrong? Here's what went wrong. So like I said, the last time we hung out was at his house. We're at his house. Everything's good. We're watching a movie and a knock on the door. It's like, okay, it's probably just like, I don't know, delivery. He's gonna tell me go in that room, like trying to rush me, like go in that room, go in that room. Obviously something fishy is going on here if he's trying to rush me to hide. So I'm like, what's going on? His wife, who is the one who was knocking on the door, heard my voice and starts yelling. So now I'm like, what did I just get myself into? I am not trying to fight nobody today. I'm definitely not gonna fight over no boy. So I'm just looking at him like, you got some explaining to do. So he goes and opens the door for his wife, and this is what happened. Story time at the time I dated a married man and his wife walked in on us. So I'm at his house and his wife knocks on the door. She's yelling. She's clearly mad. And I'm like, I am not about to get beat up. I have to defend myself. Because we all know those girls that get mad at the girl that their boyfriend cheats on them with instead of getting mad at the boyfriend. So I had to prepare myself. I put my shoes on. I had some rings in my purse. I put those on. I was ready to fight thinking I was going to get attacked. So I had to defend myself. Yeah, so he goes to open the door for his wife. She walks in and stares dead at me. And I'm just like, the most awkwardest thing ever. She looks at him and screams, you have kids! At that point, I was ready to go because I know I just got catfished. She starts going off on him and I have really bad anxiety, so I zone out. And she looks at me and she goes, who the hell are you? I snap back and I'm like, I'm 17. I don't know what's going on. I don't want any part of this. I was so fucking scared. I just wanted to get out of there. I did not know. I will leave right now. So I left. I called a friend to come get me because he's the one who drove me to his house. I don't know what happened with them, but I received this text message an hour later from his phone. Part 5 of the time I dated a married man and his wife walked in on us. So after I received that text message from her, here it is again. I texted her back and she blocked me right after. I forgot to add that in the last part when she came in and started yelling. And then she looked at me and she was like, who the hell are you? I just automatically screamed my age because I was so scared. She was like, stop lying to me because this man is damn near 30. I don't know his exact age, but he's around 30 years old. This means I had just turned 17. I was going on dates and hanging out with a man who was damn near 30 years old. The whole entire time, I was thinking that he was 19. I guess nowadays, you really cannot tell people's age. Someone could be 16 looking 25. It could be damn near 30 looking 19. And the most disgusting part of all of this is the fact that the whole entire time, he knew that I was 17. The time my crazy neighbor tried to go on a killing spree in our neighborhood. This wasn't no average killing spree. Dude had a whole rifle. He was going into people's backyard, jumping fences, literally trying to break into people's homes. Just get ready for the story time. So I don't exactly remember when this happened. It happened a few years ago when I was still in high school because I just graduated this year. And I know that another one of my friends that went to that school and lives in this same neighborhood saw him in their backyard. So this guy was literally our next door neighbor. I've lived in the same neighborhood since fourth grade and he was here when we moved here. Him and my dad honestly had a really good bond. If one of them needed a lawnmower, they would let them borrow it. And I was even in band at one point and I was selling butter braids because they do it for a fundraiser. And he bought several of my butter braids. I got hella change. I genuinely thought this man was kind-hearted until this night. I was chilling in my room and all of a sudden I see a light flashing through my window. Obviously I go to check it out and it's police. Several police. One of them waves their hand like this, trying to get me to close the blind. So I do and go tell my family what I just saw. And we hear a knock on the door. Thinking it's police, we go to open the door. And it's our crazy neighbor with a rifle.
Villain speaks righteous. Sister Cena says funky. How bizarre. How bizarre. How bizarre.
Part 2 of the time my crazy neighbor tried to go on a killing spree in our neighborhood. Like I said, we thought it was going to be police at the door. We have a doorbell, and whenever someone doesn't use our doorbell, it's usually police. I mean, the fact that I just saw the police outside, I thought it was going to be them. But no, child, it was our crazy neighbor with a rifle. Mind you, at this point in time, I did not see the rifle. I was scared. My stomach was in my ass type beat. I was hiding behind my sister. Like, y'all keep all that. Didn't see his rifle, but I did get to glance at him, though. He looked intoxicated. I don't think he was, and I'll explain that later. Yeah, as soon as my dad opens the door and our neighbor sees us, he says something along the lines of, I'm not trying to hurt anyone. Dad immediately shuts the door in his face. Dad turns around to the rest of us and tells us that he saw a rifle at his feet. At this point, I'm thinking, child, I know this man did not just knock on our door. He had to hide a gun. Then we could open the door and he could shoot us, right? Oh, hell no, it's time to evacuate. I actually called the police instead. But while one of my family members was on the phone with the dispatcher, he heard another knock on the door. This time it followed up with them announcing that they were the police. The police officer was shaking. He said we needed to evacuate immediately because our crazy neighbor was in our backyard trying to break in. Part 3 of the time my crazy neighbor tried to go on a killing spree in our neighborhood. The police knock on our door and tell us that we have to evacuate because our crazy neighbor is now in our backyard trying to break into our house. So this means that he was still on our property after we closed the door on him. He literally went to our backyard after we slammed the door in his face and was trying to figure out a way to get in through the back. Who the fuck do you expect to let you in their house if you have a rifle? Understand that he was trying to hide it, but he was not doing a very good job. Okay, so we frantically start packing. We hear yelling outside, we hear dogs barking. The police basically had him cornered in our backyard. So we had to get out of there as quickly and safely as possible. So we have police surrounding our house. We all finish packing and go inside our garage so we can get out from there because it's safer. There were literal police cars following us all the way to the hotel. Once we got into the hotel, they told us that they were going to call us when we were good to go back home. We only stayed at that hotel for one night. And once they call us the next morning to tell us that we're good to go back home, my dad asks them exactly what happened. Apparently that night there was two boys across the street playing basketball. It was really late at night and he was extremely tired and he had work the next day. He kindly came out and asked the boys to be quiet. They kept being loud and it only went downhill from there.
This could be good for me. Lately I was feeling like I need a purpose. But when you talk to me, give me the impression that I won't scratch your surface. I could walk for days, searching for your praise. But is it even there to find? Is there a chance for me to clean your memories? Will I slowly lose my mind? Lost in your maze, stuck in your gaze. How can I get out? I'm out of time. Feeling like I need a purpose. But when you talk to me, give me the impression. impression that I won't scratch your surface. I could walk for days searching for your praise. Is it even there to find?
Bathroom, me and her start talking. I ask her what she likes to do for fun. She tells me she likes playing the game dress up. So I ask her how to play. She tells me that you have to strip completely naked. The person that you're playing with dresses you up, and that she plays the game with her older brother because he's the one who taught her. Part two of how my boyfriend got away with touching his own little sister. My boyfriend's in the bathroom and his little sister tells me that she plays this game called dress up that he taught her. You strip butt ass naked. You let the person you're playing with dress you up. Obviously my mind went south. I didn't know if I should have told her in that moment if it was wrong and not normal, because I didn't want her to freak out before I got the chance to help her. So I ask her, how many times have you played this game with your older brother? She tells me that she plays it all the time and that she really likes it. So now I'm thinking he has completely groomed her. She thinks this game is completely okay. My boyfriend comes back in the room and we finish the night off watching a bunch of movies. I didn't know what else to do. So I leave his house and then the next day I call him and I ask him about this little game. The first thing he does is get mad, says that she's young and dumb and doesn't know what she's talking about, that it's wrong of me to just falsely accuse him of things like this. So he breaks up with me. I didn't really care, but I was thinking about his little sister, that I needed to get back into that house so I could ask her more questions. So I begged for him back. Even though I didn't really like him, I told him that I believed him, that I wanted to come over so we could work things out. This is what happened when I went to his house. Part three of how my boyfriend got away with touching his own little sister. So he breaks up with me after I tell him what his sister told me about this game that they play, where you strip completely naked. Yeah, that game. Me not having enough proof to take it to the authorities just yet, I beg for him back so I can go over to his house again, get more info from his little sister. For some odd reason, when I went over to his house, his little sister just wasn't anywhere to be seen. Me and him are sitting in his room watching a movie, and he goes to the bathroom. I see his little sister peek her head through the door. I'm like, hey, come here. She seems super excited to see me, and she tells me, Mom and Dad told me I couldn't talk to you anymore. So I ask her why, and she says that they told him that I was a bad person and I make up lies about people. People, including her older brother. So I ask her what lies I made up. She says they didn't tell her. Now I'm thinking, so the parents are in on it too. So I continue to ask her questions about this game that they play. I'm like, have you told your parents? She says yes, she's told her parents, that they didn't see anything wrong with it. That's just another reason for her to think that it's okay. But that's when shit goes south and her parents walk in. Part four of how my boyfriend got away with touching his own little sister. So my boyfriend's little sister tells me that their parents know about this game that she plays with her older brother, but they strip completely naked. So as she's telling me more and more, her parents walk in. It was the first time I disrespected somebody in their own home. They start yelling at her for not staying put where they told her to stay put. That way I couldn't talk to her. That's when I snap and I start going off on her parents. How I know that their son is touching their little daughter and they're not doing anything about it, and that I'm not afraid to report them. And her parents go ballistic. It's also when my boyfriend gets out of the bathroom. Mom comes up to me and tries to smack me. Dodged it. Then she's yelling and screaming at me to get out of her house. It's kind of a hard situation because I knew that if I called the police, I would have no proof of anything. I would necessarily be trespassing since they told me to get out. That little girl can't speak for herself. They groomed her. She thinks it's okay. I wasn't gonna leave that little girl in that house, so I stood my ground. That's when my boyfriend grabs me. The dad grabs me. They pick me up. I can't even make this up when I say that they threw me out their front door.